Yes. So today our session is JavaScript. Okay. So where we are going to write the JavaScript is the first question. Okay. So JavaScript is a programming language. Okay. So where we are writing actually the JavaScript and why we are writing the JavaScript? I'm just telling you the understanding about the JavaScript. Okay. JavaScript is a object-oriented language. One of the object-oriented language. Okay, so there are so many languages, object-oriented languages are available in the world. So one of them is JavaScript, and we are going to discuss later what is object-oriented and how many types of programming languages are there. All these things. Okay, so second thing, JavaScript is actually run inside the browser. So where it will execute, actually. It will execute inside the browser. Browser means what? There will be IE, like Internet Explorer browser, right? So Internet Explorer is there. Google Chrome is there, right? Like that, so many browsers are there, right? So in that browser, the JavaScript will be going to execute. There is one more place JavaScript will going to execute is Node.js. So Node.js is also one of the platform recently developed. And in the Node.js also, JavaScript is run actually. It will run means it will execute and show you the output, like your program will execute there only. So that one I'm talking about. So currently we are consider JavaScript is going to run inside the browser. Okay, that's what we need to consider for now. Okay, so next thing, how to start the JavaScript. Okay, so to start the JavaScript in the browser, that means if I wanted to run that my program, I wanted to write my program and I'll start running it, right, to see what is the instructions execution and what is the input going on and what is the output coming. All these things, if I wanted to start, then what I have to do, I have to start the HTML actually. So HTML is the thing where we actually start, and then inside the HTML, we will write the JavaScript. Okay, so why all these things are needed, all these things later I will tell you. For now, these are the, you know, bullet points we have to remember and start practicing this. Okay, so this is what it is. So JavaScript is an object-oriented language, and where the JavaScript is run, JavaScript will run inside the browser. And how I can run the JavaScript? For that, I need a HTML file. Actually, HTML is one more. It's something like a file. Okay, HTML file or HTML technology. We're going to talk about later. But that I need it, then inside that HTML only I will write the JavaScript and that will start executing. Any doubts so far? Any clarification needed? Okay, now let us see how to start the, you know, HTML then, because we have to write JavaScript inside HTML only, right? So how to start the HTML, that one I'm going to tell you now. Okay, so for that, nothing else, just you create a file actually. So I have just created a blank file or a notepad. I just open a notepad and I'm start writing it. It's very simple, and the notepad will be there in each and every system, right? Yes, that is needed, that's it. And one browser is needed, that's it. Nothing else is needed. No extra installations or anything is needed for this. Okay, we need just a notepad and browser, that's it. To execute my JavaScript program, I need a browser, that's it. Two things only needed, and that is already there in your system. So right, so you don't have to worry about installation part. Let us concentrate how to create a HTML file and how to execute it, that's it. Okay, so I just open a notepad and I'm start typing tags. Actually, HTML is a actually tagged language. Everything we can write in tag format. So what is a tag? Tag is something like, I can write like this, HTML. Okay, if you see this, HTML open and HTML close tags. This is nothing but tag. Tag means what? It's a kind of a symbolic format, like less than and writing the tag name and close greater than, and then again less than and slash and HTML and close. This is called one tag. This is called one tag. And the tags will have a parts like, this is the starting tag and that is the ending tag. This is the starting tag and this is the ending tag. Inside whatever you write, this is called information. for the tag. Okay, so like this it will go. All HTML will go like this only. Okay, so all HTML has to start with HTML tag. Okay, then inside that there will be a sub tag called. There are two sub tags will be there in HTML. Okay, so one sub tag is called head. And another sub tag is called body. Okay, so two sub tags will be there in HTML. So first sub tag is called head, another sub tag is called body. Okay, so keep the body as it is. Okay, we are going to concentrate on the head tag now. So inside head tag there will be one more sub tag called script tag. What is that? Script tag. Okay, so script tag is the tag which we need to write the JavaScript. That's what we need to understand here. Okay, so we started the HTML tag. After that we created two different tags, which is head tag and body tag, and then we are going to start the script tag inside the head tag. This is what we need to understand. So they are all parent and child relationships, and each and every tag are the predefined tags. That means all these tags are already available in HTML. Okay, so this we need to by heart. That's what I'm telling you. So we have to start with HTML, and then inside there will be head tag and body tag. Two child tags will be there, and then inside head tag, script tag should be written, and inside the script tag only we write the JavaScript program. So we have to start JavaScript program inside the script tag only. Otherwise, JavaScript program won't execute in your HTML. That's what we need to concentrate. Okay? Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. Now I have started the JavaScript, and I can write the JavaScript here, and then I will execute this. How I can execute it? I'm going to write a small statement which is called alert. Alert is a JavaScript statement. Hello, this is JavaScript. Just I will write a small message in this. Okay, so how to execute this particular statement? That's what we need to understand here. So what I will do, once I written all these things, I have to save it. Okay, while saving, what I'm going to do, you need to concentrate. Okay, so while saving, what I'm going to do here, I am actually keeping the file name, right? While I'm saving, I always keep the file name, right, for the particular file. So the file name should be anything. Okay, I will select any file name. Like for now, I'll put JavaScript demo is a file name, and spaces and other things are not recommended, only without spaces. Capital small letters is okay. If you wanted to put a space, you can put a normal dash kind of thing. Okay, so JavaScript demo is the file name. Dot html you have to always enclose with. Okay, so any file name is fine, but dot html has to be kept. That is the very important thing you people has to remember. Okay, so what you are doing now, I'm saving the file. So JavaScript dash demo is my file name. Dot html should be there for each and every file name. So I'm saving it. The moment I save it, I can see the file name is displaying in my notepad, right? JavaScript demo dot html. Okay, and also you can see that all the tags are in the colored manner, and it is actually remembering that. It is able to recognize that some format, right? That means HTML is a universal language. All the IDs, like notepad kind of things, can recognize, and it will show there is a parent tag and child tag. It will allow automatically show you the collapsible and expandable, you know, symbols and everything. That means it is basically recognizing that. That's it, nothing else. Okay, so that doesn't matter for us. Now we just saved it. How to run the program, we need to see now. How to create the HTML file, you already understood now. So let us start. See this, the moment I save it, I can see the icon here, like 1.html in the browser symbol, whatever the default browser you have, with that symbol you can see that file. Okay, so I just open it, that's it. So if I open it, it will start executing. It is opening in the browser. See, it is started executing, but this is not the file which I saved, right? So what is the file I've saved? JavaScript demo. Here it is. Did you see that? JavaScript demo.html. I'm just opening it. Did you see that? Alert is coming here. Hello, this is JavaScript. Correct?
Yes.
So this is the alert. So that means my JavaScript is actually running. So my JavaScript statement has been written here. Says hello, this is JavaScript, like that. And I'm trying to open that file into the browser. Automatically that script will start executing. So you wanted to run again, you just type enter, or else you can refresh, that will start execute again. See that? Hello, this is JavaScript. Or refresh. Hello, this is JavaScript. Right. So this is how JavaScript will run actually. Okay. So this is how we need to start the JavaScript language program. So now you can start writing your program here. So that will execute. Okay, any doubts, any clarification needed?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, now we need to understand the statements, because we already told you, na, JavaScript or any language, we need to learn the statements. Like we need to learn the tokens, then we have to learn the keywords, then the statements, all these things we already know, right? So what to learn, what not to learn in language, write a program. So here we need to concentrate on the tokens and concentrate on the keywords and then statements, all these things. Okay, I think we already started learning tokens and keywords also, right? We started learning now the statements. Okay, so this is one of the statement. This is one of the statement. Okay, so to learn the JavaScript or any language, so we should understand, we should classify the things actually. Okay, so I'm going to tell you the statements, how many types. So what are the statements actually? So how many types of statements will be there? There will be statement called input statements, and the second one will be arithmetic statements and logical statements, loop statements, output statements. Like this we can classify the statements. Okay, so there will be statements, and if you learn the statements only, you can write the program. What is the program? Program is nothing but translation of your algorithm into computer language, right? So you have an algorithm. I wanted to translate that algorithm into program. All we need to do is writing the statements only, right? So you will already have an algorithm. So I'm going to put an algorithm here, which you practiced, okay? So which is addition of two numbers, for example. So addition of two numbers is a problem statement, and for this algorithm, we'll generally write like this. Start, take a number for A. Why I started take a number for A? Before that, we are going to concentrate on the formula, right? So what is the problem statement formula? We can consider formula as C is equal to A plus B. Among them, what are the variables? What are the constants we are going to note down? So what are the constants and variables? There is no constant in this formula. Only variables will be there. A, B, and C are the variables, right? So these are the variables, and we have to always take the values for the variables, right? So that is where we were taking a value for A. That means we are actually accepting one variable from the user, first variable, and we are storing that into A. And third one, take a number or value for B, like that we can write. And this is my own language. You can write your own language. It's not, doesn't matter. You have to write it in my own way. This is my own way, and you will have your own statement, but the meaning will be the same, right? So first to start, I will write second, I will take the value for the A variable, and third, I will take a variable for B variable, and then fourth,
calculate
C is equal to A plus B, or you can say calculate A plus B and store in C, whatever, that's up to you, right? It's all our own language. Then algorithms are done in our own language. I'm telling you already, right? So display C value or display C, whatever. And then stop. This is what we do, right? This is the algorithm I have, and I wanted to write a program for this. Okay, so how to translate this? For this, we need to classify what are the kind of statements have been written. Each and every algorithm will have statements like this. There will be input statements, there will be arithmetic statement, there will be logical statement, there will be loop statement, there will be output statements, right? All these things will be there. Okay, here also start and stop is okay, that's fine, because start and stop are the actual formality. You have to start and then you should stop. Other statements you need to concentrate and consider, what are the statements are input, what are the statements are the arithmetic, what are the logical, and what are the loop statements and output statements, right? So here if you consider, take a number is a input statement, correct? Take a number for A is an input statement. I need an input statement to replace this. That means I wanted to translate entire thing into my JavaScript language, means I need some statements here. So what are the input statement available in JavaScript so that I can replace this particular line, second line, into that statement. And third line also take a number for B, that is also input statement. Fourth line is calculate C is equal to A plus B is the arithmetic statement, right? I should know arithmetic statement, then I can translate this into that, right? And then display C is the output statement. That means, do you understand what we need to learn there? So using algorithm, I am translating this algorithm. Algorithm is in my own language. I wanted to translate into computer language so that will become a program. That is what we were learning. So how to do that means this is how we do. So for that, what we need to do, we should know the JavaScript statement. These many statements are there. These many types of statements will be there. So you should know at least one arithmetic statement or one input statement, one logical and one loop and one output statement. Then you can write your programs. There are many, many. And you, how much you learn, that much you efficiently you can write program. That's what it is. Okay. So now let us concentrate. Take a number for A is an input statement, and take a number for a B is a input statement again. Let us ignore this. Take a number for A and B for now. I'm going to later tell you what are the input statements are available. But concentrate other things like calculate C and display C value. These two things. One is arithmetic, and another one is output statement. And before that, you should concentrate. There are some variables we were discussing. Like in a pharma, there are some variables, right? So these things are all very important. And to see that how I can write a program now. So first thing we should understand, there are variables in the formula, in my algorithm. A, B, C are the variables. Let you in the program, in the JavaScript, always you have to declare those variables before using. So how to declare variable, you see that. So var A, var B, and var C. So var, var, var small letter, and very important, small and capital are different. Okay, no, should not use capital letters here. It's all small letter. Var, var is a keyword here. What is that? Var is a keyword. Keyword means meaningful word. And it will tell something to the computer what to do. Okay, that's what it is where. Okay, so where keyword you are using to declare a variable. So you are declaring three variables using where keyword. Where A, where B, and where C. There is three variables is declared now. Understand? It's very simple, right? You just create a variable means you just use where keyword. Where, where space A. That means A variable is created. A is the name of the variable. You can put name for the variable, or you can put whatever I. Or you can put like pi, whatever, it's up to you. The name of the variables is up to you. No, for now I just kept A is a variable name. A, B, C, three variables are declared. Okay, now what is the next statement? And I already told you start, right? Start means what? Nothing else. The script starting and ending is considered as start and end. Nothing else here. Start is a script start tag, end is script end tag. That's it. And take a number for A. I wanted to give some number to the A, right? So for this, I need an input statement. So for now, I am not going to tell you the input statement because it involving some little complexity. So later sessions, I'm going to tell you that. For now, I'm hard code the value like A is equal to 10. I can assign some value like this. A is equal to 10. So you consider that user is given that. Okay, so you consider A is equal to 10 is given by the user for now. Okay, like that you can put B is equal to 20 as well. Because I have two statements here. Take a number for A, take a number for B. Both the numbers user will going to give. If I use the input statement, currently I am not going to use input statement, so I just given my own 10 and 20 for now. Okay, you are getting right. And next, calculate C is equal to A plus B. How I can do that? So calculate C is equal to A plus B. Something like you just write like this. C is equal to A plus B. That's it. This is arithmetic statement. Okay, arithmetic statement you can write directly like this. C is equal to A plus B means what will happen? It will calculate A plus B and store into C. That's it. Directly it will do for us. Nothing. You don't want to do anything here. You replace the operator based on that operator. It will automatically calculate. If you put into, or if you put divided by, or if you put minus, automatically that will consider that and it will do that operation and it will give you the value in C. That's what it is. Okay. Next thing is display C value. You are getting right. So the display C value, what I have to write is, I already told you alert is the one of the output statement. I'm using alert only for that. Alert C. That's it. So alert C will actually, what it will do, it will, whatever the value in C will going to display here. That's what I'm, display statement I'm using here as an alert. Okay, display statement is alert. Now you are understanding, right? So how I am using the alert, alert bracket open and C with the, which is a variable name, and bracket close and semicolon. This is very important. This is the syntax. This is the syntax for the alert. Syntax means rules and regulations for the statement. If you violate that, it won't execute. It will throw error. So you should understand that how to use it. All small alert and bracket open and variable name and bracket close semicolon. That's it. And stop. Stop is already there. So what I am doing here, I am totally replacing my algorithm into program. You are getting na? So this is one statement. First statement, take a value, right? Value for A. You are understanding or not?
Yes, sir.
Take a value for B. Yes. You are understanding? All equivalent statement will come. All we need to do is just, we are learning the one of the languages and we are just replacing that into their language statement. That's it. So that means what I told you already, if you know algorithm, then only you can write program. If you don't know, you can't do that. It's very simple. Okay, so now you understood. Now I just have a variable and variable declarations, and then I am taken the values, and I am actually using the calculate thing and storing the C, and then C value.
Display the value.
Display okay. The value. Let us run this and see what is going to happen. So to run it, I don't want to open again and again. I just refresh it. Once you open, that's enough. You just refresh. You see that your file only opened here or not? Your file only, right? Then you can just refresh. You are able to see that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So that's how you do. So you have a 10 and 20. You replace the values and run it again and again. Like I just 10 and 200 I kept. I saved it. And I'm just going there. I'm refreshing it. You see 200 plus 10 is 210. Right?
Yes.
So like that, there are so many programs, like all your normal programs you can write like this. And you can see whether it's working or not. Any clarification, any doubts so far?
No, sir.
You are getting it or not? This is very important. You guys have to practice, then only it will work, because programming things will always, you practice, then only you will learn it. If you are not practicing, you are not going to learn that. Okay. So all we need to do is, what you need to do, you just write your algorithm, okay, and then you translate that algorithm into the appropriate statements in the language. So we are learning slowly the JavaScript language, and we are just translating them into the equivalent statements. That's it. It will give you the output. You just run it, it will give you the same thing, correct? That doesn't, the nothing is going to do, whatever you written in your algorithm, the same thing will going to reflect, and it is going to show you there. And one more thing I'm going to tell you here. So you wanted to have an output, like currently the, whatever the algorithm says, the same thing is coming, like display C value. So now if you just see that display C value is coming here, but user doesn't know what is this value. Correct. So for that we can have a algorithm change. Like I'm going to write my fifth line is like this. display line as quotation your sum of your two numbers is and my value. Like, see, you are understanding?
Yes, sir.
So my output should be like this. I don't want to be like only C. I'm going to put my my line should be like this. Sum of your two numbers is, that means you given two numbers, right? Sum of your two numbers is whatever the value of C here. Okay. So like that. I want it to be display like that. Then what I have to do? So you need to do like this for that. You should write a quotation. You whatever the message you wanted to type, you should put all the messages inside a quotations.
Quotation.
Sum of your two numbers is, and then you concatenate your variable and your message. Concatenation means plus. You are actually plus. You are adding both. Like you want this one as well as this one. Both should be in the alert. That's what you are doing here. Always variable should be outside. If you put inside quotation, always you see C also will be displayed in the output. So you don't want C inside, na? You always put the variable outside. That's what you put the plus symbol and you put your variable here. That will display as it is. You are getting it or not?
Getting.
Yes, sir.
Did you see that?
Yes, sir.
Sum of your two numbers is 210. Correct. So like this, what you are learning one by one statements, and you always should not forget that any amendments or any changes needed, you go and change even your algorithm and come back and do that. You should not do directly in the program. You're getting, na? I just changed my fifth line like this in the algorithm, and then come and I'm doing the same thing in JavaScript. This is how you need to practice. Okay, so always you should have a algorithm and then you write a program for that. Algorithm and write a program, right? Like that you do. All your take things and all you only hard code here for now. In the next session, I'm going to tell you what and all the input statements available, all these things. Okay, but other statements I already told you. Arithmetic statements is very easy. A plus B is you know means A minus B. Everything is same. Everything can do like this. Okay. So you guys need to practice. So far, whatever the algorithms are there, you guys has to practice like this and see what is the output is coming. Whether your output is expected output or any errors or anything, you have to tell me in the Scratch Java group. And make it correct and then practice and come back for the next sessions. Okay. This is very important. Until unless you practice, you won't understand, because this is very new for you guys, right? You have to practice and get connected to the technology, then only you'll understand. Because going for it will go inside so many other statements, so many different languages, so many different capabilities of JavaScript. All these things will come into the picture. That time you should understand those things. Means you should be very very capable of writing algorithms, and all basic stuff should be understandable. Then only it will be easy to catch the things. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So you guys, I hope you will be practicing all your existing algorithms with this. And any errors comes. For example, any error comes. I write some program without plus. I did not kept the plus. This is very syntax. I told you, na. I did not follow the syntax correctly. I saved it. And I'm going and running it. Did you see alert here? Nothing is going to see here. But you right click and go to inspect. Okay. You will going to see the error. Whatever the errors coming, that will be going to display there. So this is called developer tools. If you right click in the in your browser and go to inspect, then what is going to come here is called, it came here, na? That is called developer tools. I'm going to tell you what is that and all. You go to console. What is this? There are so many tabs came. You open the console and you see all your errors here. Uncat syntax error, missing something, something. Right? And it's going to tell you the line number also JavaScript demo HTML 14th line is the problem. Okay, and you go and see in the 14th line, this is the problem. Okay, you put plus and save and go and run. You will able to run it. No alert, nothing, no errors will come. You are able to see the alert, right? This is how it is. You are understanding? To open the developer tools, you can just open the browser and press F12. F12 will open the developer tools, or else you right click and go to inspect. Inspect will open the developer tools. Inside the developer tool, you can always choose the console. Console will be the place where all your JavaScript is executed. So there will be HTML also in elements. There will be console and there will be source where all other files like JavaScript files, CSS files will open there. So many things are there. Later we'll see why all these things are there and all. So currently you just open the console and see your program is running properly or not. All your errors and everything will noted here. Nothing will noted in the browser. It will always go behind the browser. That is called console. Okay, this is user don't know whether it's console is there or not. Nothing user will know, right? User just to see here it is not working, something like that. So developer will see that how, why it is not working, where is there, all these things he will see here. He will open the developer tool and see there. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Fine. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.